Greetings world, we are Anonymous. A truly fearful foreign intelligence service, SVR, urgent action report circulating in the Kremlin today states that Germany's Federal Intelligence Service, BND, shocking dismissal yesterday of over 300 elite police officers from protecting the lives of President Donald Trump and President Vladimir Putin at next week's G20 meeting in Hamburg is due to their being infiltrated by an elite organization of American assassins responsible for the worst political murders in U.S. history, and one of whose provable assassination attempts was in 1979 against President Jimmy Carter, who, like Trump, vowed to restore the United States government to its people. According to this report, what is known about these elite American assassins is that they are CIA-trained Cuban mercenaries whose association with the President John F. Kennedy patsy assassin Lee Harvey Oswald at a secret CIA base in the swamps of Louisiana was confirmed last year by declassified top-secret U.S. documents, and that the American History Channel television network began to air a series about earlier this year, but was suddenly canceled in the United States with residents of Canada being the only ones allowed to view it. After the November 22, 1963 assassination of President Kennedy, this report continues, the next provable, confirmed appearance of these CIA-trained Cuban mercenaries was on May 5, 1979 when Raymond Lee Harvey was apprehended by the U.S. Secret Service prior to his and the other assassins involved being able to kill President Jimmy Carter during a speech was about to give at the Civic Center Mall in Los Angeles, California. Like Lee Harvey Oswald before him, this report details, Raymond Lee Harvey was supposed to be the patsy of the four-man assassination team killing President Carter, and whose only other identified member was Oswaldo Espinoza Ortiz, but both being subsequently released from custody without any explanations from U.S. authorities. As to why President Carter was targeted for assassination, this report explains, was his preparing to warn the American people that their government had been taken over by a deep state cabal intent upon destroying their nation, but that this assassination plot keep him from being able to deliver. 2 months later, on July 5, 1979, this report says, President Carter was set again to deliver this speech to the American people, but was warned that if did he, and maybe his family members too, would be killed, thus causing him to be the first U.S. president in history to cancel a nationwide televised speech, with one account of this extraordinary event stating. So while national park officials and fireworks operators worried about rain and the citizens of the nation's capital waited in gas lines or stayed home, Carter placed a call from Camp David to the White House. Vice President Walter Mondale joined Jordan, Powell, and Rafshoon on phones. Cancel it. The president's words hissed over telephone wires. Rafshoon flew into a panic. This had never happened before, never, not in the course of American history had a president canceled a speech with no explanation. Rafshoon complained that he had already called the television networks and asked them to block out the time. Calling them back wouldn't be easy. This is not the image we want to project, Rafshoon argued. Carter rebuffed his image man. There's more to it than energy, Carter explained. And then to underscore his point, as if the exhaustion and curtness in his voice weren't enough, he blurted out, I just don't want to bullshit the American people. The advisors grew shocked at these words but continued to protest. So Carter hung up on them. Jody Powell looked at the others in the room with grief. He knew he'd have to make a statement the next day. The best he could come up with was short and perfunctory. There would be no speech, he announced, and then followed that with a no further comment. And then the president seemed to disappear. 10 days later, on July 15, 1979, this report continues, President Carter reappeared from hiding and finally spoke to the American people in a nationwide address now referred to as his malaise speech and wherein he warned of the forces seeking to destroy the United States and cryptically stated, we were sure that ours was a nation of the ballot, not the bullet, until the murders of John Kennedy and Robert Kennedy and Martin Luther King Jr. Though many among the leftist communists controlling the deep state in America like to compare President Trump to President Richard Nixon, this report says, many of that nation's more sober thinkers are now rightly noting that he can only be compared with President Carter, as both of them had vowed to restore the United States, make it great again, and drain the swamp if they were elected. And like President Carter before him, this report continues, President Trump is, likewise, enduring one of the worst, and most vile, deep state attacks ever undertaken in American history, and as evidenced by the American nightly television newscasts devoting 91% of their coverage to smearing Trump with fake news Russian allegations, while at the same time over 93% of all the U.S. television news networks and media outlets are nothing more than negative news filled with lies about him. 2. If President Trump will align himself with his deep state coup plotters in order to save his and his family's lives, this report warns, is still not fully known, but an indication that he is doing so appeared this week when his White House suddenly lied that Syria was preparing a chemical weapons attack, with their refusing to offer any proof this was so, and that is a grave violation of the UN Charter. Western leaders seeking to provoke World War III by making up such lies, this report further warns, are, also, in full violation of Section 51(1) of the British International Criminal Court Act 2001-2, and that British Prime Minister Theresa May is currently under a war crimes investigation for after her stating her willingness to conduct indiscriminate mass slaughter by using nuclear missiles against Russia. 2. The SVR's most feared assassination scenario involving President Trump at next week's G20 meeting in Hamburg, this report concludes, is that should these assassins be successful, the American deep state will blame President Trump's murder on Russia, thus justifying their initiation of World War III, and that their elites are prepared for with their being able to rapidly flee to their underground bunkers while tens of millions of ordinary American citizens die. We are anonymous. We are Legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.